Hello everybody and welcome back to Jaltest VLOGS. Today we're going to go over some of the basics on how to solve problems with your Jaltest. So anytime they have a software issue or there's a problem that you don't know how to go about, if you follow these steps one by one, you're probably going to be able to solve it on your own. If that's not enough or the problem is persistent, then you can call us and we'll help you out there. So the first thing we're going to do is go into our question mark. We click on here and we have an option which is FAQ. So as it says, it's your frequently asked questions. Here it's going to show you what we've compiled throughout the years of things that generate the most problems. How can I renew my Jaltest license? How can I use a tool after it expires? Or things like how do I generate an expert mode? They are all hyperlinks. So you click on there and it'll take you to the actual question. It'll give you the procedures and you can continue. Follow them, everything's done. If you scroll down more, for example, can you do skid steers and loaders? This talks to you about the upgrades. So all the questions that you need to go through would be here, okay? The next step is gonna be, we're having training videos. So what you're looking at right now is one of our Jaltest VLOGs, but they're also training videos. They're included within the software. So you click here and it's gonna launch you the whole options. You're gonna be able to click on one of these and it'll have a direct link to our YouTube account. So you're gonna be able to see these videos directly from the software or go to our Jaltest YouTube channel. After that, one of the main problems that we have are connections, so battery issues. We go to preferences, click on Jaltest link, and then run a connection test. We're talking about electronics on trucks, so if the voltage is under 12 volts, like right now since we're on demo mode, it says USB, you're not gonna get connection to the ECMs properly. So if it's telling you that it can't identify anything and you go in here and it's under 12, that's the issue. Put it on a jumper, start the engine or whatever, and you'll be able to get through that. A new thing that has come up is troubleshooting on the actual errors. So let's say that we're actually in a system. We're going to be into, let's do your Caterpillar C13 again. Click on here, connect to our system, and then we connect. All right. Select our connector. Now it would be connected directly to the system. So I'm going to generate a code purposely. So I'm going to disconnect my USB connector once it finishes, and it's going to bring out a connection fault. So we're going to do a calibration, ejector exchange, we accept the expert mode, and then here we're going to have the issue. I'll try to continue. Right now my USB is disconnected. And here we have it, connection fault 005. That means connection error with Jaltest blockage or electrical power supply. So for most of us, we don't really know what that means. Basically, to make it more simple, there's a question mark and it's going to give you a step-by-step on how to go about repairing this code or troubleshooting it. So it shows up here and it's going to give you error in the communication with Jaltest link. It will give you a description, communication error, possible causes, USB cable has been disconnected, which is our case. The adapter has been disconnected from the PC, blockage or loss of power supply. And then the most important part, how to solve it. In this case, check the USB connection. After that, check the Bluetooth connection. If you were on Bluetooth, restart and try again. Try another vehicle. If the problem persists, then we contact remote assistance. That's what we're talking about, okay? So those are a few steps that you're gonna be able to access before giving us a call and probably solve most of the problems. Now, if all that's not enough, then you click on here and remote assistance. This is the way that we can remote into your computer. So it's gonna launch a TeamViewer app where you're gonna get a user and a password. Okay, so I'm gonna minimize this because mine's in the back. And here you have it, user ID and password. You have to call us with that information or send us an email with that data, and we're capable of remoting in. Now the question is, what if I don't have access to your phone number? Once again, help menu, you're gonna go down here, contact details. Right here on the right, Kajali USA, here you have our phone line, here you have your 1-800, and you can send us the information at customersupport@jaltest.com and we'll be able to get back to you. So anytime that you have a problem, so if you follow these steps, you'll probably be learning in the process, probably get it done faster. And if all else fails, give us a call, we'll remote in and we'll assist you in the repair. So once again, thank you for joining us on VLOGs and see you in one of the next ones.